NH2. So let me see that one on slide like everything. Let me see. Now, what are amino acids here? If you observe amino means which group beta? Amines, which group they are? NH2. Acids will have what group beta? COOH. So collectively, any compound which contains amino group, that means NH2 group, and carboxylic group here, they are called as what? Amino acids. So these amino acids are actually building blocks of proteins here. So they are made upon by peptide bond. Peptide bond means it looks like this. NHC double bond O. This is called what? Peptide bond. We'll discuss later this one. Everything we'll discuss later in detail. So what I mean to say in this one, what are amino acids? The compounds which are having amine group and carboxylic group, they are called what? Amino acids. Now, very important thing for examination point of view. This is very important. Being as a biology students, you know this one, I think. When you do hydrolysis of proteins, which amino acids we get here? Alpha amino acids. The question arises, what are alpha amino acids? The question is what? What are alpha amino acids? Already I told you, alpha means. Now we have to see what happened. This is a functional group. Main functional group means higher priority functional group. Which one is higher priority beta? Amine or carboxylic acid? Which is higher priority?
Carboxylic acid.
So adjacent to the functional group carbon is called alpha carbon. Now this is alpha carbon because it is adjacent to functional group. Now amine group is on which carbon? Alpha or beta carbon? Amine group is on which carbon? Alpha or beta carbon?
Alpha carbon.
So when amine present on alpha carbon of this carboxylic acid, then they are called alpha amino acids. In alpha amino acid, amine group is present on alpha carbon. Now, we are having 20 different amino acids are there. There are 20 amino acids are there. How they differ? By R group. When you change this R group, we get 20 different amino acids we get here. The 20 different amino acids depends upon this R actually. Some may, though, two, three will be vary because of their cyclic structure. Slightly they vary. But when you change this R, for example, if I put here hydrogen in the place of R, if I put hydrogen, then this amino acid is called what actually? Glycine. If I put in the place of R, if I put CH3, that amino acid is called what? Alanine. Like that, we can write N number of alpha amino acids. Let me see all these now. First of all, we'll see that all the nomenclatures. First one, glycine. I told you in the place of R, you put hydrogen, then that is called what? Glycine. Take first three letters for nomenclature gly, one letter G. Next one, alanine. R means what we can put here? CH3. Then you can take what? ALA, first three letters. Then capital A will be the code for us. Third one, valine. Valine. We can take R equal to CH3 to CH. Iso group we can take. Iso group. Okay. Something CH3, CH something. First three letters. Capital V the code. Fourth one, leucine. CH3, that means for compared to this one, it is having one extra CH2, one extra carbon you are having. How you would memorize this one? Compared to this, this is something like this. CH3, CH, CH3. In the place of R, we can take like this. Extra, it is having one more CH2 group that you are calling as leucine here. Take the again symbol LEU, first three letters, and code will be what? L. I completed four amino acids. One is glycine, alanine, valine, leucine. Now, what is the meaning of this star? I explain what is the meaning of this star later in the classification of essential, non-essential. So leave it there. Next, we'll go to what? Fifth one. I think you are having textbook, you can see from textbook also. Now, in this case, what happened? The CH3 is what here? Isoleucine. You see, second carbon is having methyl. Leucine is what? Previous case you have taken leucine. right? This is the leucine. Now this one will be what? Isoleucine. Now actually, what is the difference you are observing here? Isoleucine means you can take this in ILE, first letter, this one, okay? And code will be what? I actually, right? Next, arginine, this one is the R. ARG you can take. This one will be what? Same code you are taken what? R. Lysine, LYS, okay? LYS, glutamic acid, GLU, right? Glutamic acid means, glycine means NH2CH2 taken four times. Glutamic acid, COOH CH2 CH2, like this. It's an acid. I will explain that one later. Aspartic acid, glutamine, aspartame, theonine. These are all R groups only. Just we are placing in the place of R. Actually, NH2, CH, COOH. Now, in the place of R here, you are placing these groups actually over here. Here actually. 13th one, serine, cysteine, thionine, phenylalanine, tyrosine, tryptophan, histidine, proline. This is the last structure, chlorine. Here, if you observe what happened, here it is not R group beta. It is not called R group. It is amino acid only, isn't it? It is complete amino acid. Here, there is no R group beta. Remember this one. It is only amino acid. This is alpha carbon. Alpha carbon is having amine group. Alpha carbon is having the remaining one. What they are having R groups one. Remaining there what R groups. Remember this one. Proline is what exception case. Now, whether in examination you have to remember all these structures, no need. Generally, in examination, what happened? They don't ask the structures, so no need for you. But what you have to remember, let me see this one in the classification of amino acids. Now, three types of classifications are there. These are important. Based on the position of NH2 group, I told you if NH2 group present on the alpha carbon, therefore they are alpha amino acids. If it is present on beta carbon, beta amino acids, like that we can say. You observe here what happened? This is a functional group. Alpha carbon, now NH2 group present on alpha carbon, therefore alpha amino acid. Now what are beta amino acids? You observe here. This is alpha carbon, because functional group it is a functional group. Alpha carbon, and NH2 present on which carbon, beta amino acids. This is a thing you need to remember, right? Gamma amino acids means NH2 group present on what? This is a functional group, alpha, beta, gamma. Now NH2 group present on what? Gamma carbon, isn't it? So this is about what actually? Gamma amino acids. Now this glycine is what type of example here? Alpha amino acids, right? What will be the answer, beta?
CC.
Both C. NH2 and COOH groups, right? Is it possible, beta, based on the
cysteine,
isn't it? This type of they may ask sulfur containing amino acids, like that they may ask here, but they don't all write the structure of cysteine. Okay, right. The next classification is very important, beta. Nature, based on the nature. For example, you see in all alpha amino acids, how many amine groups or how many COOH groups you are having? Acid based on example, right? COOH. Now, isn't it? If you observe this one, how many amine groups are there in this one, beta? How many carboxyl groups are there here? In this structure, what I have written here? Whatever I have written over here, how many amine groups are there? How many carboxylic acids are there in this?
One.
Therefore, they are neutral only. But when you have more carboxylic groups, they can be called as acidic in nature. When you have more nitrogen groups, they can be called as basic groups. So here, based on the number of NH2 groups and COOH groups, if NH2, that means nitrogen are dominating, that will be base. COOH groups are dominating, in that case, there will be acidic nature. So I am writing here what three natures here. Acidic nature, basic nature, neutral nature. Let me see what are acidic in nature, which are comes under acidic nature here. Now in this, what is dominating? COOH groups are dominating. Amino acids in which COOH groups are more, compared with NH2 groups, they are called what? Acidic amino acids. You take glutamic acid better. You take glutamic acid. It's a glutamic acid. Just now you've seen this one. You take textbook also. Here one carboxylic group is there, and here one carboxylic group, and one amine is there. One amine, okay, and two carboxylic acids are there. So definitely it will glutamic acid. The name also, this it is given as acid here. Easy, you can remember. Glutamic acid is which type of thing? Acidic amino acid. Now next we'll take the second one, basic amino acids. Basic amino acids in which NH2 groups are dominating. You observe what happened? Here it will be what? OH. Right? Now, how many NH2 groups are there? Two NH2 groups. So therefore, it is called what? Basic amino acid. Example name is called lysine, I have taken. So lysine comes under what actually? Basic amino acids. Right? Now, neutral amino acids means what happened? There are equal number here. Amine groups are equal, carboxylic groups are both are what same here. In that case, they comes under what happened? Neutral amino acids. You take here glycine is a best example. One NH2 group, one alanine is a best example, isn't it? Otherwise, what happened? Leucine is a best example. Isoleucine is a best example for what happened? Neutral amino acids. Understood better? So in examination, what happened? You may get this type of questions in MCQs or whatever it may be. Following which is what? Acidic, basic, something like that were asked. They may ask also. Now, I will ask you some questions here. If you observe what happened, proline is which type of nature beta? Proline 21. Do fast. Proline is which type of
neutral?
Neutral. I am writing over here. Histidine, you observe more number of nitrogens are you are observing. This is R group beta. Still, you are having what? One COOH group is there, one NH2 group is there. Apart from that, you are having this is R group here. So, it will be basic in nature. Tryptophan. Nitrogen is there, basic in nature. Tyrosine, neutral in nature because it's R group. This entire thing is R. R does not have neither carboxylic nor amine group. It will be neutral. We'll take next one. Phenylalanine, anybody? Do fast.
Neutral.
Amine and carboxylic group here. No. So neutral, 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 neutral. Next one, let me see now, next thing. This one will be, is this carboxylic acid? 309? No, neutral. What about aspergine?
Acidic.
Acidic. This is not carboxylic group beta. Amide group it is. Little basic because of lone pair, little bit basic but not basic, small basic it is, weakly basic it is, very least. Now this one also will be same because of lone pairs, but it will be comes under what happened because lone pairs will move to here, no? Now this one will be what? Definitely what happened? Acidic only, clearly showing what? COOH group. This one will be what? Acidic. This one will be lysine, purely basic. Because of lone pairs of nitrogen. Arginine is also what happened? Purely basic. Basic it is. Leucine is what? Neutral. Leucine again? Neutral. Valine? Neutral. Alanine? Neutral. Glycine? Neutral. Understood how to identify? But in examination, they don't give the structure beta. So that is the reason what you do, whatever the acidic amino acids are there, you write separately. Names only, don't write any structures, leave it the structures here. Okay, and write on the basic one separately, and remaining will be what definitely? No need to write remaining. Remaining will be definitely what happened? Neutral amino acids. Understood? You write acidic only or few are there? Three, four, three are there? Something what happened? And remaining something four or what? Basic are there? So remaining 12 something what? 12, 13 what? They are neutral only, right? In that way, you can easily remember. Next, we'll see one more classification based on their importance: essential amino acids, non-essential amino acids. Now, what are essential amino acids? Let me see. What is the meaning of essential amino acids here? Essential amino acids means we have taken food because body cannot make that one. Body cannot produce this type of amino acids, so we have take intake in the food action. So the amino acids cannot be synthesized in the body. They are called what? Essential amino acids. What are the examples we can take? Valine, leucine, isoleucine. See, these will be there in the tonics. Whenever what happened, you are not feeling well, you are suffering from fever, what happened? Doctor will prescribe you, isn't it, a tonic for you for getting strength. In that case, what happened? This leucine, isn't it, will be there. Because it is not synthesized in the body. So what are essential amino acids? Which can be, cannot be synthesized in the body, can be taken in the food, called what? Essential amino acids. Now in your table, textbook, wherever star mark is given, no, that star mark indicates essential amino acids. You take in the textbook, in that what happened? They mention what happened. Yes, star mark, I will show that one, no problem. They're what actually? Essential amino acids. Now what are non-essential? Because they are synthesized in the body, no need to take in the food action. They are synthesized in the body, so no need to take in the food. Therefore, they are called what? Non-essential amino acids. What are the examples we can take? Glycine, alanine, glutamic acid. The non-star this one. That comes under what happened? Non-essential amino acids. Give essential amino acid, which one is better? What is the one's answer for this one? This type of questions you may get in examination.
Isoleucine
is the essential. So remember essential better, leave it the non-essential. That's it better. You remember essential, leave it the non-essential. I will give some shortcut for you also. Later I will give the shortcut for you how to remember this essential only. I will give a shortcut for you later in the basic amino acids they are asking. What are the basic amino acids here? You say what?
Lysine and
arginine. Right, very good. Lysine is having NH2 group here. So based upon, you can say even arginine is also having NH2 group here. So this will be the one. In this way, you will get some questions. So acidic amino acids, in that name also is given here. So directly we can say, what is
aspartic
acid only, right? Next small thing only is there. Only 2-3 minutes it will complete. The properties of the amino acids. Generally, they are colorless, crystalline solids. They solve in water. Why they are solve in water better, amino acids? Why they soluble in the water? Because
H-bond.
It is polar in nature. Amino acids are polar in nature because they are having COOH group. COOH group is nothing but having a polarity in there. They are having high melting bank, isn't it? Because of that charges, zwitterion will be formed. I will show, explain that one later. Behaves like salt rather than the simple amino acids. Or carbon, they behave as a salt. I will explain these two things. Why it is behaving as salt, I will explain by taking example as zwitterion later in the slide. Yes, you see now zwitterion. What is the meaning of zwitterion? I told you in the last class only. Here you got zwitterion. In the which shop you got zwitterion better? In which chapter you got zwitterion better?
Amines,
right, very good. Now what happens here? I'm showing something like COOH giving a proton, releasing a proton. Why it is releasing a proton better, anybody? Why it is releasing a proton, anybody? Because it is acid. Simple thing, because it is acid. Now what is the function of base better? What is the function of base? Accept the proton. Okay, minus H plus will be accepted by the proton. Now what we are going to get? This structure we are going to get. R, CH, COO minus and NH3 plus. Now this molecule is having both charges, positive charge and negative charges. Therefore it is called what? is bitter ion. A dipolar ion. A dipole. Don't write zwitter ion means a dipole. Of course, it is a dipolar ion, but don't write the definition here. You write like that here. You write like this definition, it will be easy for you. Okay? Don't remember the definition, remember this concept here. This concept, if you remember what happened, you can write in your own words. This is what actually is zwitter ion. So one more thing, what happened when you are writing what nomenclature? I already told what happened. Tire, we can use that one. Alpha amino acids. Already we know this. Now let me see what happened. Important one, very very important one. Now tell me, it is D alanine or L alanine? D or L? Capital D configuration. Configuration bit. Configuration. D or L? D configuration or L configuration bit? Are you there or not? D or L? First carbon, second carbon. Higher priority, which one? Which is having highest atomic number beta? Hydrogen or nitrogen? Among these two, which is higher priority?
Nitrogen
is the first priority group. First priority group here. Which side it is having? Left side. So which configuration we have to give? L alanine I have to call this one. Which alanine I have to call? L alanine. Now here, all these amino acids are having L configurations. All amino acids are having which type of configuration beta? L configuration there. Next thing, what is isoelectric point? What is the meaning of isoelectrical point? Now when you observe, because of zwitter ion, can you say it is acid or base? Based upon zwitter ion nature, can you say it is acid or base beta? Tell me which one it is, acid or base? Tell me, is it acid or base? Salt it is. The salt. Just now I told you, no. Here, in this previous slide. Behaves like a salt. They behaves like what? Salt. Why? Because rather than simple amines and carboxylic acid, they are behaving as salt. Why? Because of zwitter nature here. Zwitter ion nature, isn't it? Having negative charge and positive charge over it, exhibiting as what here? Salt nature actually, isn't it? Now, what is the electrical point? The pH at which amine acid does not migrate to cathode or anode in electrical field is called what? Isoelectrical point. Okay? The pH at which, at what pH? At 5.5 to 6.3, these amino acid does not move to what? Either cathode or anode here in electrical field, because of what actually? Zwitter ion nature. Also, generally for neutral amino acids, what happened? It will be 5.5. Basic amino acids will be 7.76 to 10.8. But in examination, nobody asked this one. Just they will ask isoelectrical point. Remember isoelectrical point, leave it this one. Okay, what is isoelectrical point? At this pH, neutral amino acids does not move what? At cathode or anode in the electrical field actually. And this one is known as one. Now, how to get the peptide bond? We'll discuss tomorrow, right? How do we get this peptide bond, dipeptide bond, tripeptide bond? We'll discuss tomorrow actually, right?